Ladies and gentlemen, believe it or not, but today I'm in an abandoned military base in the Netherlands. This is an airstrip that used to be used for airplanes. And this whole area is a natural reserve / abandoned military base. And today we're going to explore it on YouTube. Ladies and gentlemen, guess where I am today? Today I'm in an abandoned military base in the Netherlands that has been open to the public. Not only that, part of it is now a natural reserve. So the idea is that nature will overtake this area, while some of it is still being maintained for its unique cultural history. So I thought, why not? Why not show you today on YouTube? Let's go. Park Vliegbasis Soesterberg is the name of this place. And believe it or not, it is an airbase that was used in World War I, World War II and the Cold War. However, after the Cold War, the Berlin Wall was finally torn down, and I guess the usefulness of this airbase diminished. The airbase was not closed down immediately, but gradually fell into decline, as it was used less and less for small operations. Until in 2008, the government finally decided that keeping it operational is too costly for the little use it provides. However, it has found a new function, helping Mother Nature. Since it has fallen into decline, nature is taking the airbase back from humans, and now it's being maintained as a nature reserve. Firebugs can be seen doing their mating rituals between the cracks and the tiles of the airstrip, for example. Yes, they look threatening, but these brightly colored bugs that mate in spring are actually vegetarians that mostly feed on mallow and lime tree seeds. In spring, they often gather to mate. These signs warn visitors not to disturb the Eurasian skylark, Alauda arvensis, which are birds that appear to be nesting around the abandoned airstrips, for example. That's right, who would have thought an airbase could be a home to so many species? I wish humans did more to give land back to nature, to be honest. I can only cheer for initiatives like these. Calling the airbase completely abandoned would be a lie, however. Recreationally, it's being used for glider aircraft nowadays. A glider, or a sailplane, is a type of glider aircraft used in leisure activity and sport of gliding. This unpowered aircraft can use naturally occurring currents of rising air in the atmosphere to gain altitude. Kind of like a bird of prey that uses thermal air currents in order to glide, if you've seen that behavior before. As it turns out, I guess this sport is popular here because a massive number of gliders was constantly coming and going. Or perhaps it is just because it's one of the first sunny days in spring after a long and dreadful winter. It makes sense that people do it here of all places. There's probably no better place to lift off than an abandoned airbase. Maar ik heb hier. It didn't take me very long to spot the first butterflies in spring. It's currently April, so many species are coming out of hibernation. This bright and yellow cutie here is named the brimstone butterfly, or Goniopteryx rhamni. The flight of the brimstone butterflies is extremely fast and also unpredictable, so getting a good video of them is very troublesome and challenging. Wait, it landed. Wow, my lucky shot. It just landed on a flower in front of me.
Do Here in the back I can show you something cool. They decided to exhibit some weaponry and airplanes to the public. If there are any military enthusiasts watching this right now, I'd love to hear your opinion on this kind of stuff. Some of you will recognize that a lot of these weapons and airplanes belong to the American Air Force and not a Dutch one. That's because this base was mostly operated by the Americans when it was still operational. And there is another fun fact that may blow your mind. Turns out my grandfather used to work here when he was young. Yep, my grandpa was in the military. For almost 40 years, United States Air Force facilities at Soesterberg, named Camp New Amsterdam, was a major frontline airbase during the Cold War. The base was closed on December 31, 2008 due to budget cuts in the Dutch Army. The airbase ceased flying operations on November in 2008 when the command was transferred from the Dutch Air Force to the Dutch Defense, who will take care of the base until it will be given back to nature. In World War I and World War II, the airfield was used as well. In World War I, the Netherlands was neutral, so we didn't really use it to wage war. Instead, we used it for patrol missions and for confiscating foreign aircraft that flew into our airspace. In World War II, we got occupied by the Nazis pretty fast. In just 5 days' time, Hitler conquered the Netherlands. Well, we aren't a big country, so that's to be expected. So during World War II, the airfield was operated by the Germans and their bombers. And a variety of German aircraft were stationed here during the war, flying anti-shipping missions along British convoy routes in the North Sea and doing bombing missions over England. Personally, I think this place is a really nice piece of history. If you visit the Netherlands, especially in summer, I recommend checking it out on a warm day.
Waarom moet je nou?
Dit komt in de video!
Je gaat toch audiosporen slepen?
Ah, laat maar.
Even worstelen.
Dat niet.
Alright guys, let's continue to explore some of the nature around the airbase. And then I saw a completely pink moth. Can you see it? I believe it's a purple-barred yellow. Lytria cruentaria is the scientific name. Usually these moths are yellow and pink, but the level of pinkness can vary. Still, I think the moths that have this much pink on their wings are pretty rare, since most individuals usually have pink stripes and yellow wings. I've never seen one with such uniformly pink forewings myself, so that was a lucky moment. Unfortunately, I only have a very small amount of footage of this insect. I just thought it was cool. The host plant of these moths is sorrel. Unfortunately, they are so small and fast, it's very hard to film them.
Wow, kijk! Kijk, zie je hem gaan? Daar gaat hij.
Let's go deeper in the forest and surrounding area. Check this out. There are a lot of abandoned bunkers in the landscape.
Kijk, alle mieren.
Nice.
Turns out there was a lot of ant activity around the roads. This made me want to find the source. With some luck, I could find the nest.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's our lucky day. Guess what I found here on the forest floor? A giant anthill. Now I must be very careful not to touch them, because these guys can sting. But can you see this? This whole hill here is made by forest ants, and it's a huge colony. Wow.
These are redwood ants. There are multiple species of them, and identifying them based on a video or picture isn't very feasible, especially for a guy with no expertise in ants like me. I will identify them as Formica rufa or a related species, but they were absolutely covering the forest roads, which make me think there was a huge colony nearby. These ants have multiple and huge interconnected colonies and feed on things such as the sweet honeydew secreted by aphids, but they will also hunt other insects for proteins. Nests of these ants are large, conspicuous, and dome-shaped mounds of grass, twigs, or conifer needles, and they often build their nests against rotting tree stumps, usually situated in woodland clearings, where the sun's rays can reach them. Large colonies may have over 10,000 up to 500,000 workers, and 100 queens. These ants are very strong scavengers and hunters and contribute to healthy forests by keeping pests under control. What I saw next were munition bunkers. These are probably used to store explosives and munitions and other types of ammunition.
Well, take a look, ladies and gentlemen. I've spotted something here in the grass. You probably can't see it, but I can give you a close-up of what's down here.
Wait, a lizard? The Netherlands has lizards? That's right, we do. Several species of them, in fact. This is one of the more common ones, the sand lizard, Lacerta agilis. In the Netherlands, this species is mostly restricted to sand dunes and heathlands. Although this specimen is beautifully green, the females of this species are just plain brown. Unfortunately, this species is declining due to habitat loss, so my guess is a good thing that they found shelter around this airbase.
Thank you.
and then finally what seemed like a small pond. The water was thriving with many interesting life forms. There were many types of salamanders, which are now in the prime of their breeding season. It's pretty interesting how quickly nature is reclaiming this place, and it just shows how easily humans can help the environment by simply giving it a little bit more space. Well, that was most of it, ladies and gentlemen. We are now ending the end of this video. We are going home. Due to the virus, there is a curfew in the Netherlands and we have to get indoors before 10 o'clock. Feel free to stick around to find out what I'm eating for dinner, however. I guess that we were hungry.
Kan ook een boterham als je wil. Nee, ik doe ook gewoon cola light. Misschien niet. Ja, ja. Hallo, mag ik één cola light voor je alsjeblieft?
Eén cola light.
Ja,
2,75 geef aan. Met ijs?
Ah ja.
Ja,
dank je wel.
Want heb je alles vast?
Sorry, chai latte?
Ja, vanille.
Vanille? Dat was hem.
Ja. 2,09.
Ja. Dank je wel.
Jij wel?
Ja. Ik ga vast even naar buiten, ja.
Ik doe de deur wel open. Thanks, Ben Ben. Welke staat hier voor? Oh. Oh my god, I love this place.
Ja, het is leuk, hè?
Kan je dit nou eten zonder te knoeien? Oh wacht, dat kan niet. Loop daar eens.
Hey guys, it's Bart here. Please don't pay attention to these moths. They're for a video for later that I will be releasing later this month. Did you enjoy the video of me exploring the abandoned airbase in Soest? Well, I'm happy for that. I hope you enjoy it. I can show you more places in my country that you would like to see. But if we do, please keep in mind my channel is 100% demonetized. If I make a video and I upload it on YouTube, YouTube will never pay me for the views I get. And the thing about traveling around the country is that it's expensive because I spent a significant amount of budget on bus tickets and train tickets, simply because I'm dependent on public transport a lot. And basically all the funds that I crowdfund online are the funds I use to travel or make videos like this. So if you enjoy my content, consider subbing to my Patreon, contributing to Ko-fi, PayPal, LiberaPay. There's many more options in the descriptions below this video. Sorry for the internet begging. This channel is 100% crowdfunded. So it is honestly the support I get from my viewers that make it possible for me to do anything on this channel. Thank you and see you next time.